بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله. اما بعد، نبدا باذن الله تعالى بدراسه الدروس المهمه لعامه الامه للشيخ بن باز رحمه الله تعالى.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. So we'll begin with the next lesson, which is the text important lessons for the common Muslims of the Ummah by Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah.
هذه الدروس المهمة قبل البدء بالدراسة على ما اعتدنا عليه نسأل لماذا ندرس الدروس المهمة.
So before we start this lesson, like we've previously done, the first question we need to understand is why do we need to study these important lessons, this book, the important lessons.
لأنها مهمة.
Because, as is in the title, because they're important, important lessons.
طالما أنها مهمة فلا بد من دراسة هذه الدروس، وهذا هو نصيحة العلماء.
So therefore, if these lessons are important, as is in the title, then we have to study them. And this is the advice of the scholars.
بعد هذا لو قال لك قائد نعم هذه دروس مهمة لكن مهمة لعامة الأمة وأنا لست من عوام الأمة أنا طالب علم.
So if a person comes to you and he says to you, okay, these lessons are important as is in the title. However, these lessons are important for the common Muslims because in the title it says الدروس المهمة لعامة الأمة, important lesson for the common Muslims. So a person comes and he says, yes, these lessons are important but for the common Muslims. I'm not a common Muslim, I'm a student of knowledge, I'm a طالب العلم.
يعني هذا يتكبر على العلم والعلماء.
However, this type of person, he's being arrogant over علم and the scholars.
فنقول لهذا.
So we say to this type of person,
نعم هذه الدروس المهمة لعامة الأمة.
Yes, these important lessons are for common Muslims.
نسألك عما فيها.
And let's ask you about the things that are in them.
من شروط لا إله إلا الله.
Do you know the conditions of لا إله إلا الله؟
وشروط الصلاة.
Do you know the conditions of the prayer؟
وأركان الصلاة وواجبات الصلاة.
Do you know the pillars of the prayer؟ Do you know the obligations of the prayer؟
سنن الصلاة ومفترات الصلاة.
Do you know the recommended acts of the prayer؟ Do you know those things which invalidate prayer؟
إلى آخر مما هو في الدروس المهمة.
And all the various other things that are mentioned inside this book at the Rusum when my important lessons.
فإن أجاب فالحمد لله فهو أعلى من عوام الأمة.
So if he is able to answer these questions, then alhamdulillah, praise due to Allah, this person is above the common Muslim.
وإن لم يجب فهو دون عوام الأمة.
And if he's not able to answer, then he's more or less than the common Muslims. So this person, if he doesn't know the answers to these questions of what's in the book, then this person's more low than the common Muslims, because at least the common Muslim has a sense of modesty and humbleness, meaning he wants to learn. However, this one, he's arrogant, he doesn't want to learn. And anybody who is arrogant and proud will never be able to seek knowledge. So, in the usual order, like we've mentioned before, when you buy a book, or when a book is given to you, what is the index or the contents of this book?
المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى فهرسها وجعلها دروس.
So the author himself, Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah, the author himself, he made an index for this book, and he made every single subject a separate lesson.
مجمل ما ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى في هذه الدروس.
So generally speaking, what is contained in these lessons? Number one, that which relates to memorizing the Quran on the way of the Salaf. And that which relates to at-tawheed. And that which relates to the description of the prayer, how the prayer should be prayed. And the conditions of the prayer, the pillars, the obligations. And also those matters that relate to al-wudu, the ablution and purification of tahara. And also that which relates to preparing the deceased body for funeral and the funeral itself. And also, finally, the correct manners and morals. The correct Islamic manners and morals.
هذا مجمل ما ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى في هذه الدروس فهي ولله الحمد يعني شاملة للأشياء المهمة التي يحتاج إليها المسلم.
So So this is, generally speaking, this is what the author has mentioned in his book, Ad-Durus al-Muhimma. And this is, and all praise due to Allah, what a common Muslim or everyday Muslim would need in his life.
نبدأ بالدرس الأول.
So let's start with the first lesson.
الدرس الأول طريقة السلف مع القرآن.
So the first lesson is the way or the methodology of the Salaf in how they learned or studied the Quran.
السلف رحمهم الله لم يتركوا حفظ القرآن.
The Salaf, may Allah have mercy upon them, and when we say Salaf, we're talking about the great scholars who came previously, especially the first three generations. So the Salaf, they never left alone memorizing Quran.
ولم يحفظ القرآن من دون تدبر.
And they never memorized Quran without pondering and contemplating over it.
فالذي على طريقة السلف حقا لا بد أن يسير على ما كان عليه السلف من أن يحفظ في كل يوم.
So the one who is upon the way of the Salaf, then he has to be upon the way in terms of memorizing every single day.
ثم ينظر في تفسير هذه الآيات حتى وإن كان النظر في تفسير هذه الآيات إلى تفسير مختصر كتفسير الإمام ابن سعد رحمه الله تعالى.
And then every day when you're memorizing, you also look up the tafsir, the explanation of the ayat that you've memorized. Even if it's a very summarized, very concise type of tafsir, such as the tafsir of Sheikh Nasr al-Sa'di, of the Mani Nasr al-Sa'di. تفسير السعدي.
وهذا بإذن الله لا يكلفك شيء وتكون بهذا على طريقة السلف فتحرص بكل يوم أن تحفظ يوميا الحفظ يكون يومي وبخاصة على ما ذكر المؤلف لقصار السور الفاتحة وقصار السور أي من الضحى إلى الناس نعم.
So this is the way of the Salaf and this isn't something and our praise to, due to Allah which will be too difficult on you. Every day memorize small number of ayat every single day and reads a concise tafsir about it. And if you do this every single day, then you'll be upon the way of the Salaf and it won't take too long. And especially that you should memorize the shortest chapters, the shorter surah. Like Shaykh Ibn Baz rahimahullah mentioned, from Surah Al-Duha all the way to the end, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ.
لِأَنَّ هَذِهِ السُّورَ صَلَى السُّورَ وَالْفَاتِحَةَ تُكَرَّرْ دَائِمًا فِي الصَّلَاةِ الْمَفْرُوضَةِ.
Because these short chapters or these short surah and surah al-Fatiha, you'll come across them again over and over in the prayer all the time they're reciting the prayer.
هذا هو الدرس الأول.
So this is the first lesson.
أما الدرس الثاني والثالث وما بعد هذا ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى أكثر من درس في التوحيد.
As for the second, third, and a few of the lessons, then the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, I Sheikh Ibn Baz. He mentioned a number of issues relating to التوحيد.
ثم بعد هذا ذكر ما يتعلق بالصلاة.
And then after this, he mentioned that which relates to the prayer, الصلاة.
ونحن إن شاء الله تعالى يعني نطبق الآن صفة صلاة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأن هذه السنة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قام على المنبر وصلى وقال إنما فعلت هذا لتأتموا بي ولتعلموا صلاتي.
So what we're going to do is now, when it comes to the description of the prayer, we're going to implement, I practically teach how the prayer should be prayed. And this is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he stood on the minbar and he prayed, وقال,
إنما فعلت هذا لتأتموا بي ولتعلموا صلاتي.
That I've only done this, I practically, so that you can follow me. And that you can pray like I've prayed.
وقال صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said صلوا, pray as you have seen me praying.
وكل واحد منا يظن أنه يصلي على ما صلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And every single one amongst us thinks that he is praying according to the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم how he prayed.
ولكن هذه السنة حتى يعرف الإنسان هل هو وافق ما عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أم لا.
So this, what we're going to teach now, this is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So each one of you can judge whether you are praying according to the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
وعلى هذا سار الصحابة والسلف الصالح رضوان الله عليهم كانوا يطبقوا صفة صلاة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أمام الناس.
And in this way, the companions, the Sahaba, and also the great Imams and the scholars of the Salaf, this is what they used to do. They used to practically teach and implement in front of the people how to pray the prayer.
فنحن الآن نطبق إن شاء الله الصفة.
So now we're going to practically display or implement the way of the description of the prayer.
ثم بعد أن ننتهي كما هي العادة نجتمع يجتمع كل مجموعة ويصلي كل واحد منهم أمام البقية حتى يلاحظوا لو كان عليه شيء.
And then after we've done this, we're going to do what we've been doing so far, that you go back into your small groups and each one of you prays, you know, a unit for example, so the others can sit around and say, you're making a mistake here, or you're doing this right, and you can correct and advise each other.
ذكرنا بالأمس,
we mentioned yesterday
أن المسلم يتطهر في بيته,
that a Muslim, he should purify himself in his house.
نعم. ثم يمشي للمسجد.
And then he walks to the masjid.
عليه السكينة والوقار.
And he walks to the masjid in a manner of being calm and tranquil.
السكينة في الحركات.
So being calm in terms of your movements.
يعني لا يجري.
So you don't run.
أو يحرك يديه مثلا.
You don't move your hands around like this.
والوقار في الهيئة.
And وقار being calm in terms of.
يعني مثلا. لا يرفع الصوت أو يتكلم في الجوار بصوت مرتفع.
So for example, you don't raise your voice. You know, you don't become a nuisance. You don't speak on your phone loud.
أو يكون يعني يلبس اللباس وهو في الطريق وكذا.
Or for example, somebody's walking and you're trying to put on clothes and take off clothes.
نعم. هذا وهو قادم إلى المسجد. فما بالك إذا دخل المسجد.
So this is for the one who is coming to the masjid. And then how then when one enters the masjid?
فإذا دخل إلى المسجد.
So if then the brother or the person enters into the masjid.
قدم الرجل اليمنى.
He enters with his right foot.
وذكر الدعاء الوارد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And he mentions the supplication which has been raised by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فإذا كانت الصلاة قد أقيمت والإمام يصلي.
So if the prayer has already been established and the Imam is praying.
دخل مع الإمام في أي هيئة الإمام هو عليها.
He enters in the prayer with the rest of the congregation and the Imam in any way that the Imam is.
حتى وإن كان في التشهد الأخير يدخل معه.
Meaning even if the Imam is in the last part of the prayer, the تشهد الأخير, the last تشهد, the last sitting, he sits with them straight away.
وإذا لم تقم الصلاة بعد.
And if the prayer hasn't yet been established.
صلى إما السنة القبلية أو تحية المسجد.
Then the person should pray either the voluntary prayers that come before the prayer, if they exist, or tahiyatul masjid, the two units of entering the masjid.
ولا يقف كما يسمع بعض الشباب هدانا الله إياهم.
And he shouldn't just stand there at the back like some of the youth stand. May Allah guide them and guide us.
أو يلتفت أو ينظر في الساعة.
Oh, he keeps looking at his watch.
بعد هذا.
And then after this.
لابد أن نعرف أن الصلاة لها شروط وأركان وواجبات وسنن ومفضلات.
We have to know, we have to understand that the prayer, it has conditions which are called shurut, it has arkan which are pillars, it has wajibat which are obligations, it has sunan which are recommended acts, voluntary acts, and it also has muqtalat, those things which break or invalidate your prayer.
من يعرف شروط الصلاة?
So who knows the conditions of the prayer?
شروط الصلاة.
The conditions of the prayer.
ما شاء الله. طيب. الشرط الأول.
Okay, the first condition.
الإسلام.
الإسلام.
نعم.
The first condition is Islam.
سبحان الله. ما يصلي للمسلم.
Because only Muslim prays.
كل واحد يدخل المسجد فهو مسلم. لماذا نقول من شروط الصلاة الإسلام?
The Sheikh is saying that it's obvious that nobody enters into the masjid to pray except he's a Muslim. So then, why do we say that Islam is a condition for the prayer if it's so obvious?
لأنه قد يصلي وهو مشرك نسأل الله السلامة عليه.
Because a person could pray and yet he's a mushrik. We ask Allah to save his.
ولذلك لابد أن نتعلم التوحيد أولا.
And therefore the first thing we have to learn is التوحيد.
حتى لا تكون العبادة باطلة.
So that the worship isn't invalid or false.
إذا لو صلى الكافر فصلاته.
So if a disbeliever prays and his prayer is
باطل.
False, invalid, not accepted.
إذا لابد أن تحذر من الشرك لأن الشرك إذا دخل في العبادة أفسدها.
And therefore you have to be very cautious and be aware and be careful of shirk because if shirk enters into your worship it'll corrupt all of it.
الثاني.
The second condition.
العقل.
The second condition is an intellect, العقل.
فلو صلى المجنون فصلاته.
So if a person who's insane, if he prayed then his prayer is
باطل.
Invalid, not accepted.
طيب لو صلى السكران.
Okay, if a drunk person, he prayed.
هل صلاته صحيحة أم باطل?
Is his prayer correct or incorrect? Accepted or not accepted? Raise your hands.
نعم.
صحيح.
صحيحة. لأنه ليس المجنون.
So the brother said that the prayer of a drunk person is correct because he's not majnun, he's not insane.
نعم. بل المجنون أحسن منه.
Rather the majnun, the insane person is better than the drunk person.
لأن المجنون جن بغير اختيار.
Because the insane person, he's lost his sanity, but not to his own choice or his own will.
لكن هذا مجنون وزيادة.
But this drunk person, he's even more insane.
في هل يوجد عاقل يعرف الحضارة والتقدم ولديه شيء من يعني من العقل يذهب هذا العقل الذي أعطاه الله إياه؟
Can it be possible that you have an intelligent person, somebody who has intelligence, and he's civilized, and he has, you know, he's sophisticated, and yet he chooses to get rid of his own intellect?
والله لو يعرض الخمر على البهائم ما تشربه والله.
Said by Allah, even if alcohol was given to the cattle, then they wouldn't drink it. Even the cattle wouldn't drink alcohol.
كيف عاقل يشرب خمر?
But how is it possible that an intelligent person drinks alcohol?
فلو صلى السكران فصلاته باطلة من باب أولى.
So therefore, if a drunk person prays, then his prayer is invalid even more than the insane person.
نعم.
البلوغ.
التمييز.
التمييز. The third condition is التمييز.
التمييز أي التفريق بين الأشياء.
And التمييز, the meaning of التمييز is a young child reaching an age where he or she can distinguish between things.
نعم. فإذا كان يعرف أنه تقول له هذا ماء وهذا لا يعرف. تقول له اجلس يجلس. يعرف السؤال ويعرف الجواب.
So if the young child reaches an age whereby if you said to him this is water, this is a fire, he understands this. If you said to him or her stand, sit, understands questions, then this is a tamiz. This is the
age. تصح صلاة الصغير.
So therefore, is the prayer of a young child accepted?
نعم تصح إذا كان يميز أو يفرق بين الأشياء.
Yes, it is correct. It is correct and accepted if the child is able to distinguish between things.
وإذا كان لا يميز بين الأشياء فصلاته باطلة.
As for if the child is so young that he or she isn't able to distinguish between these things, he hasn't reached the level of tamiz or the age of tamiz, then the prayer isn't correct.
الإسلام.
So the conditions of the prayer are al-Islam,
wal-Aql,
al-Aql, a sound intellect,
wal-Tamiz,
al-Tamiz, the age of distinguishing,
al-Tafriq bayna al-Ashya, wal-Niyya,
and then fourthly al-Niyya, the intention.
Al-Niyya,
so the intention.
يقول اللهم إن نويت أن أصلي في هذا اليوم.
A person says that, oh Allah, I have intended to pray such a prayer on this day.
يوم الاثنين.
On Monday,
الموافق للتاسع عشر من شهر أغسطس,
which is corresponding to the 19th of August,
مصليا,
praying,
خلف,
behind,
الإمام عباس,
this Imam Abdul Wahid,
عبد الواحد,
this Imam Abdul Wahid,
وبجانب عن اليمين,
and on my right is
نفيد,
نفيد,
وبجانب عن اليسار محمد,
and on my left is Sheikh Haytham,
مصليا صلاة الظهر أربع ركعات,
I am praying صلاة الظهر four ركعات.
على توقيت لندن.
According to the time in London.
الساعة الخامسة.
5 o'clock.
45 دقيقة.
And 45 minutes.
فسره لي وتقبله مني يا رب العالمين.
So then Allah accept this from me.
هل يصح هذا?
Is this correct?
لا.
No, it's not correct.
النية محلها القلب والتلفظ بها بدعة.
Rather, the intention, the place of the intention is in the heart. And to pronounce your utter upon the tongue is a bid'ah, an innovation.
ممكن وهو يقول هذا الكلام يقول الإمام قد سجد.
Maybe while he's saying all of this intention, the Imam's already going to sujood.
نعم. إذن الإسلام والعقل والتمييز والنية.
So therefore, the four conditions are al-Islam, a person being a Muslim, al-Aql, sound intellect, al-Tamyiz, the age of distinguishing, and al-Niyya, the intention.
طهارة الحلم.
الطهارة.
So the next, the fifth condition is al-tahara, purification.
Wa al-tahara min ma'ala.
So purification from what?
Tahara al-hadath wa izalat al-najas.
Na'am. Izalat al-najasa wa raf' al-hadath.
So purification from two things.
Izalat al-najasa.
So purification from two things. The first of these things is izalat al-najasa, meaning.
Amma'ala yuzil al-najasa.
So izalat al-najasa meaning removing any impurity. So what type of impurity, or from where should a person remove the impurity?
Izalat al-najasa an al-badan,
from the body. A person has to remove all impurities from the body.
وعن الثوب,
and your clothing.
وعن المكان الذي يصلي,
and also the place that you're going to pray in.
ثم رفع الحدث,
and then after this رفع الحدث
الأكبر والأصغر.
So رفع الحدث, it refers to a spiritual state of cleanliness, and this can either be, and a physical state, and this can either be a major type of impurity or a minor state of impurity.
رفع الحدث الأكبر يكون بالاغتسال.
So removing the major type of impurity, i.e. janaba, this is by performing ghusl.
رفع الحدث الأصغر يكون بالوضوء.
And as for removing or purifying yourself from the minor state of impurity, then this is with wudu, ablution.
فلو صلى وعليه حدث أكبر أو حدث أصغر.
So if a person prays and upon him or he's in a state of major impurity or minor impurity,
أو على ثوب نجاسة أو في على بدنه أو يصلي في مكان نجس.
Or if a person on his thobe, on his clothing, he has some najasa, some impurity. Or the place that he's praying in, he has impurity. Or on his body, there's some impurity.
فصلاته باطلة.
Then his prayer is invalid and not accepted, incorrect.
نعم.
استقبال القبلة.
And the next condition, هذا السابع.
نعم.
The seventh condition is facing the qibla.
فلا بد من استقبال القبلة.
So therefore, a person has to face the qibla.
في الفريضة وفي النافلة.
Or in the fard prayers and the nafil prayers.
إلا أنه إذا صلى النافلة في السفر حيث توجهت به الطائرة أو القطار أو السيارة فهذا يصح في الفريضة في النافلة دون الفريضة.
So the facing of the qibla is a condition in the fariḍa, the fard prayers and the nafil prayers. However, if he's let's say in a car or on an airplane or in the train, in the voluntary prayers, the nafil prayers, then wherever the mode of transport faces, then you can pray this. This is in the nafil prayer, not the fariḍa prayer, not the obligatory prayer.
Satr al-awra.
And then from the eighth condition, the eighth condition is covering the awra. Covering the private area, private parts of the body.
وهذه مسألة مهمة جدا.
And this is a very important issue.
بخاصة من يصلي في البنطال.
Especially regarding those people who pray in trousers.
نحن الآن لا نتكلم عن حكم البنطال وكذا. نتكلم عن صحة الصلاة.
So now we're not talking about the ruling of praying in trousers. We're talking about whether the prayer is correct or incorrect.
عندما الآن يركع أو يسجد، ففي الغالب من يصلي في البنطال تنكشف سوءته.
So often when a person prays wearing trousers, then some of his behind will become uncovered.
فتكون صلاته باطلة.
And therefore his prayer is باطل. It's incorrect or invalid.
فلا بد أن يحتاط قبل الدخول في الصلاة حتى لا تنكشف العورة وبخاصة أثناء الركوع والسجود.
So therefore a person has to take caution that his awra is fully covered before he enters the prayer. Especially when he's going to go down to the ruku, when he's bowing, or in sujood, the prostration. So therefore, the awra, the private area of a male that should be covered, is from between the knees and the navel.
مع استحباب ستر العاتقين وأخذ كامل الزينة في الصلاة.
And it is recommended that both the shoulders are also covered, from the shoulders downwards. And also that you wear clothes that are nice and beautiful.
أما المرأة الحرة البالغة,
as for the woman who is free and has reached the age of puberty,
فتستر جميع البدن,
then she has to cover all of her body,
إلا وجهها,
except her face,
وعند حضور غير المحارم تغطي حتى الوجه,
and when people are around her that aren't from her male relatives, then she has to cover even her face.
نعم. طيب بعدها.
Okay, after this,
دخول الوقت. فلو صلى قبل الوقت فالصلاة باطلة. تعمد إخراج الصلاة عن وقتها كذلك الصلاة باطلة. نعم.
So after this, which is the ninth condition, is that the correct time for the prayer has to enter. So if a person prays in other than the correct time, then his prayer is batil. It's not accepted, it's invalid. And if a person on purpose delays his prayer until the time leaves, then his prayer is batil. It's not correct. It's it's not accepted, it's invalid.
يأتي بشروط الصلاة قبل الدخول في الصلاة.
So a person has to fulfill these conditions before entering into the prayer.
ثم بعد هذا يبدأ يصلي.
And then after this he begins to pray.
يعني حقق الإسلام.
Meaning a person has actualized Islam, he's a Muslim.
وهو عاقل غير مجنون.
And he has intellect, he's sane and he's not insane.
ومميز أو بالغ.
And the young child has reached the age of distinction.
ونوى بقلبه.
And he has the intention in his heart.
وأزال النجاسة.
And he has removed all forms of impurity.
ورفع الحدث الأكبر والأصغر.
And also removing major and minor impurity.
واستقبل القبلة.
And he has faced the قبلة.
ودخل الوقت.
And the time has entered.
وستر العورة.
And he has covered his or her private parts.
الآن يصلي.
So now he or she can begin to pray.
نعم. يستقبل القبلة على ما ذكرنا ويأتي بشروط الصلاة.
So the first thing is he faces the Qibla as we mentioned and fulfills all the conditions.
يضع الرجلين أو القدمين على استقامة البدن. نعم. يعني يضع القدمين على استقامة البدن.
So in terms of the positioning of his feet, it's to the level of his body.
لكن يعني القدمين لا يضم هكذا ولا يفرجهما.
So his feet don't point outwards like this, and neither do they point inwards like this.
الآن هو يبين الوضع الصحيح.
So this is now the correct way of placing his feet.
ينظر إلى استقامة الرجل من الخارج لا من الداخل من هنا من الخارج.
So in terms of his feet being straight, then he looks at the outer, obviously not the inside. So the outer of his feet are straight.
على استقامة البدن.
According to the position of the body, straight, parallel.
الآن نطبق الأخطاء.
So now he's going to show you the errors that people make. So making him too wide, the feet too wide is a mistake. And this is more than the level of the body, or being parallel with the body, the shoulders. Or he makes them too close to each other. Or he makes his feet like this. Or pointing outwards like this.
أين ينظر في صلاته؟
Okay, where does a person look when he's praying?
ينظر دائما إلى موضع السجود.
He always looks at the place that he's prostrating in.
إلا في التشهد ينظر إلى السبابة.
Except in the تشهد, i.e. the sitting, then he looks at his index finger.
ولا يلتفت.
And he doesn't turn around.
فالالتفات اليسير مكروه.
So turning around a little bit, this is something which is disliked in the prayer.
والالتفات الكثير أو رفع البصر إلى السماء محرم ومبطل للصلاة.
And as for turning around too much or raising his sight to the skies or to the ceiling, then this is haram, impermissible, and it invalidates the prayer.
الآن يكبر تكبيرة الإحرام.
Now he begins by saying the تكبيرة الإحرام.
هل تكبيرة الإحرام هي رفع اليدين؟
Is the meaning of تكبيرة الإحرام raising the hands?
لا. تكبيرة الإحرام هي قول الله أكبر.
No. The meaning of تكبيرة الإحرام is to say الله أكبر.
هل يقول شيء قبل قول الله أكبر اللهم نويت أن أصلي في هذا اليوم الاثنين؟
Does he say anything before الله أكبر meaning I have intended to pray on Monday?
لا.
No.
يكبر مباشر.
Rather he says الله أكبر straight away.
نعم. يكبر تكبيرة الإحرام مع رفع اليدين.
He says الله أكبر the تكبيرة الإحرام at the same time as raising his hands.
يجعلها مضمومة الأصابع.
When he raises his hands, he makes sure his fingers are close together.
حذو الأذنين.
And on the level of his ears.
أو حذو المنكبين.
Or the level of his shoulders, the ears or the shoulders.
إما أن تكون حذو الأذنين أو حذو المنكبين.
Either parallel to the level of the ears or parallel to the level of the shoulders.
وبعض الكفين للقبلة.
And his palms are facing the قبلة.
هذا هو الوضع الصحيح.
So this is the correct manner.
الآن نطبق الأخطاء.
Now he's going to show you the mistakes.
يفرج يديه.
spreads his fingers, mistake.
يجعلهما أي بعض الكفين جهة خدين.
He makes the palms face his ears or his face.
يمس شحمة الأذنين.
He touches the bottom of his ears.
يقبل حلو الرأس أعلى الرأس.
He takes it over his head, his old mistakes.
أو حلو السرة.
Or to the level of his navel.
هذه كلها أخطاء.
All of these are errors when it comes to takbir and raising your hands.
ثم ماذا يصنع بعد هذا؟
And then what does he do after doing this?
يضع بعض الكف اليمنى على ظاهر كف اليسرى والرزق والساعد. يعني هذا الباطن يحمل أشياء ثلاثة.
So,
ظاهر الكف والمفصل وشيء من الساعد هكذا.
So as you can see from the Sheikh, that he takes the palm of his right hand and he places it on the outer part of his left hand on three things: some of the hand and the wrist and some of the forearm, like this.
إذن يضع هذا الباطن المنتصف على المفصل هنا هكذا وضع.
So therefore he places the middle of his right palm on his wrist like this.
مضمومة الأصابع.
And the fingers are together.
أو يضم هكذا يقبل.
Or he can, and also he can hold his left hand wrist.
على الصدر.
On his chest.
نعم. الأخطاء.
Okay, the mistakes.
الأخطاء الآن. يضع هنا على هكذا. بعض الناس هو يعني هكذا, هذا ليس بقول أصلا. يضع هكذا.
So from amongst the mistakes is for a person to raise his hands up to his neck, and this isn't even called القبض.
أو على سرته.
Or he places down on his navel.
أو تحت السرة.
Or below his navel.
أو يسدل.
Or he leaves them by his sides.
أو يضع على قلبه.
Or he places it on his heart, on the left hand side of his heart.
أو على خاصرته.
Or on his hip.
نعم. فماذا كيف يضع؟
So how should a person, what should a person do?
نعم. أنا شاء أنت وق. كلهم يطبقوا الآن.
So all of you, the Sheikh wants to see all of you.
لا.
Doing it correctly.
يعني البعض يضع هكذا. لا يصح هكذا. يضم هكذا.
So don't spread your fingers out. Some of you spreading your fingers out. Keep your fingers together.
أي نعم. طيب أو يقبل هكذا.
Or you can, if you want, hold your hand, your wrist.
طيب ماذا يقول الآن؟
So what should he say now?
ماذا يقول الآن؟
What should he say now?
نعم. دعاء الاستفتاح.
He should say the opening دعاء. It is called دعاء الاستفتاح. The دعاء
تكبيرة الإحرام ركن.
So the تكبيرة الإحرام meaning saying الله أكبر. This is a pillar.
ودعاء الاستفتاح سنة.
And the dua of istiftah, this opening supplication, is a sunnah.
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وتبارك اسمك وتعالى جدك ولا إله غيره. أو غير هذا من أدعية الاستفتاح.
So you can mention the supplication that the Sheikh mentioned, or any other supplications that have been rated by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in his sunnah.
ثم يستعيد ويبسمل.
And then after this, he says the استعاذة, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. After this, he says the Bismillah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
ثم بعد هذا يقرأ الفاتحة.
And then after this, a person recites the فاتحة.
لابد أن يقرأ الفاتحة كاملة.
So the person has to recite all of Surah al-Fatiha.
مرتبة.
In order.
بآياتها.
With its verses.
وكلماتها.
And its words.
وحروفها.
And its letters.
وحركاتها.
And even the various vowels.
لو ترك منها شيء فالصلاة باطلة.
If he leaves a single part of this, then the prayer is incorrect, invalid, not accepted.
في أي ركعة يقرأ الفاتحة؟ في كل ركعة.
In which unit does he recite Surah Al-Fatiha? In every single unit, in this manner.
في السرية وفي الجهرية.
In his quiet prayers, meaning when the Imam is quiet and he is quiet, and also the loud prayers.
وفي الفريضة وفي النافلة.
In the obligatory prayers and also the voluntary prayers.
إذا قراءة الفاتحة ركن.
And therefore the recitation of Surah Al-Fatiha is a pillar, a rukn.
نعم. إلا إذا أدرك الإمام راكعا يدخل مع الإمام وسقطت عنه الفاتحة بقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Except in one situation, and that is that when the person walks in, if he comes late to the prayer, the Imam is already in his ruku'. So here, the obligation of reciting the Fatiha no longer exists. And therefore, he goes into ruku' without mentioning the Fatiha. And this is according to
veneration of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
ثم بعد هذا يستحب له قراءة سورة.
And then after this, it is recommended, it's mustahab, it is recommended for a person to recite a surah.
أراد أن يقرأ سورة الإخلاص قل هو الله أحد.
So let's say the person praying, he wanted to recite سورة الإخلاص قل هو الله أحد.
هل يستعيد مرة أخرى لأنه استعاد قبل قراءة الفاتحة؟
Should he say the isti'adha, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم again, even though he already said it previously?
لا لا يستعيد تكفير استعادة الأولى.
No, he doesn't need to say أعوذ بالله again because he already said it previously.
هل يبسمل يقول بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم؟
Does he say the bismillah, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم؟
نعم لأنه يقرأ من أول السورة.
Yes, because he's reciting from the beginning of the surah.
وإذا أراد أن يقرأ من وسط السور أو من أواخر السور لا يبسمل كما لو أراد أن يقرأ آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه.
So if a person is reciting from the middle of a surah or the end of a surah, then there's no need to say bismillah. Like for example, if you recite the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, Aman al-Rasul, those ayat.
فإذا انتهى من القراءة.
So when he has finished from his recitation ayat of the surah,
يسكت سكتة لطيفة جدا تفصل بين القراءة وتكبيرة الركوع.
If he has finished his recitation, then he has a short momentary pause of silence, so he can distinguish between the ending of his recitation and the next takbir. Takbir.
ثم بعد هذا.
So then after this.
يرفع يديه كما رفع في تكبيرة الإحرام حذو الأذنين أو حذو المنكبين ممدودة مضمومة الأصابع متجه بها إلى القبلة قائلا الله أكبر ويركع.
So then after this, once he has done the recitation and a small amount of silence, then once again he raises his hands. As he raises his hands in takbirat al-ihram at the beginning of the prayer, in that the hands, the fingers are together facing the qibla and the palms are facing outwards and to the level of the ears or the shoulder, one of the two.
Now, kabbir with Allah.
Allahu Akbar.
لابد في الركوع من أن يكون الظهر على استقامة واحدة مع الرأس.
So when a person is bowing in the ruku', then his head and his back has to be level.
نعم يضع باطن كفيه على ركبتيه.
So he places his palms on his knees.
مفرجة الأصابع.
And his fingers are spread out now.
ولا يثني مرفقيه. لا يثنيهما. يجعله ممدودة.
And he doesn't point his elbows outwards.
لأنه مجرد أن يثني المرفقين ينثني الظهر.
Because as soon as he bends or points his elbows outward, outwards, then his back's going to go down. So he keeps his elbows like this straight or his arms straight.
لا يطأطأ الرأس ولا يرفع الرأس على استقامة واحدة مع الظهر.
So he doesn't allow his head to drop down too much, nor raise up too high. Rather, parallel to the back, his back with the back.
نعم الآن نطبق الأخطاء.
So now he's going to show you the errors in the bowing.
يرفع رأسه.
Raising his head.
أو يطبق أكثر من الظهر.
Or lowering too much.
أو يثني المرفقين.
Or bending or pointing out his elbows.
أو يضع باطن الكفين على الفخذين.
Or for example a person who places his palms on his thighs.
أو على الساقين.
Or upon his shin.
أو بينهما على الفخذين هنا بين الركوع.
Oh. Okay.
هنا بينهما.
Oh, on the inside of the legs.
نعم. الآن يطبق كلما الركوع للقبلة قلنا.
Okay, so all of you now facing the قبلة, spread out. Make the correct ركوع. Just the ركوع.
لكن إلى القبلة.
Towards the قبلة.
نعم. تعال هنا تعال هنا. تعال.
Come forward, أخي.
أيوة. الله المشي. اركع.
So he's saying keep your elbows straight, not just straight, not bend them.
That's how I do it. Yeah, no, hold.
You can sit down.
Hold. Now.
Sit down, okay. Good.
الحمد لله. لا شوف هذا ركوع خطأ. هذا ركوع خطأ. انزل شوية انزل.
So pay attention to your fingers that they're not close together, they're spread out. And they're on your knees and your back is straight when you're looking at the place of prostration. Okay, so can the two brothers come to the front, please?
البقية يتابع مع بعضهم البعض.
Facing the Qibla. خلاص يجلسوا. إيه يجلسوا. Okay, so if you sit down.
أي أبقى.
شش.
ما أدري. إيه هكذا بس. الحمد لله جيد.
So that's correct. It's level. So what should a person say in the ruku', in the bowing? Don't you know what you say? Put your hand up.
سبحان ربي العظيم مرة واحدة.
A person says سبحان ربي العظيم one time.
وجوبا.
And this is the obligation to say at least one time.
يجب أن يقول مرة واحدة سبحان ربي العظيم.
So therefore it's an obligation to say سبحان ربي العظيم at least once in your record.
ويستحب له أن يزيد الثانية والثالثة وهكذا.
And it's recommended to say more than that, two, three and more.
نعم. أو يزيد على سبحان ربي العظيم بما ورد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
A person can say other things on top of سبحان ربي العظيم that has been narrated by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
سبح قدوس رب الملائكة والروح سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك اللهم اغفر لي وغير هذا مما ورد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So all of these supplications, they're not supplications, the narration that have been mentioned from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in terms of exalting Allah.
بين الركوع اركع وبين الاعتدال يرفع يديه مع قول سمع الله لمن حمده.
So
بين الركوع وبين الرفع الاعتدال يعني بينهما يرفع يديه مع قول سمع الله لمن حمده.
So during or whilst a person is rising from his ركوع to standing up at the same time he raises his hands and he says سمع الله لمن حمده.
لأن الخطأ الذي يحصل هنا أنه يقول سمع الله لمن حمده إذا استقام وهذا خطأ. And هنا موضع قول ربنا ولك الحمد.
Because the mistake that often occurs is that once the person has stood up then he says سمع الله لمن حمده. And this is a mistake. Rather, once you have stood up then you have said ربنا ولك الحمد. So you say سمع الله لمن حمده as you're standing up. During getting from the ركوع.
نعم.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
إذا استقام هنا الآن يقول
ربنا ولك الحمد.
نعم.
So once the person has now stood up and he is straight, he says, like the brother said, ربنا ولك الحمد.
نطبق الخطأ الآن.
So now we're going to show the errors.
نعم. يرفع وهنا يقول سمع الله لمن حمده مع رفع يديه. هذا خطأ.
So this is a mistake that now he's got up. And once he's straight, he says, سمع الله لمن حمده. This is a mistake.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
هذا هو الخطأ.
So this is a mistake.
إذن بين الركوع وبين الرفع يقول سمع الله لمن حمده.
So between or during getting up from the ركوع to standing up, during this time he says, سمع الله لمن حمده.
نعم.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الآن استقام هنا يقول ربنا ولك الحمد. ما حكم قول سمع الله لمن حمده وربنا ولك الحمد؟ هذه واجب من واجبات الصلاة. فقول سمع الله لمن حمده على الإمام والمنفرد واجب. وربنا ولك الحمد على الكل على الجميع.
So
قول سمع الله لمن حمده واجبة على الإمام والمنفرد. وليس المؤتم الذي يصلي خلف الإمام. أما قول ربنا ولك الحمد يجب على الكل.
So once he has now stood straight up, he says, "Rabbana wa lakal hamd." So saying, "Sami Allahu liman hamida," this is an obligation upon the imam and the person who is praying alone, but not upon the person who is behind the imam. So if you're praying in congregation, then you don't say "Sami Allahu liman hamida." As for the statement "Rabbana wa lakal hamd," then this is an obligation upon the imam, upon everybody, the imam. The person who's praying alone and the person who's praying in the congregation behind the imam.
ثم يزيد بما ورد.
And then a person can increase in terms of the remembrances that have been mentioned, that have been narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
لربي الحمد لربي الحمد لربي الحمد.
So you can say this three times.
طيبا مباركا فيه. نعم. طيب ثم بعد هذا يسجد.
So then after this, after doing all of this, he goes down into prostration, as sujood.
ما في المستشفى هنا
قريب؟
أنت تعال هنا عشان الأصوات. أكثر ما يكون خطأ وخلل وقد يكون مبطل للصلاة في حال السجود.
So the biggest, the most errors or the biggest mistakes that take place is in the sujood, and this can often be an invalidation of the prayer.
يضع باطن أصابع الرجلين على الأرض.
So a person should place the bottom of his toes on the earth.
يرص عقبي يضمهم.
And he places his ankles together.
يضع باطن الكفين على الأرض مع ضم الأصابع متجه بها للقبلة.
And then a person places his palms, the inside of his hands, on the earth with his fingers together facing the Qibla.
حذو الأذنين أو حذو المنكبين.
To the level of his ears or his shoulders.
يجافي بين أشياء ثلاثة. مجافاة مباعدة. يباعد بين العمود والصدر وبين البطن والفخذ وبين الفخذ والساق.
So a person, so a person has to make space or make space between three things.
العضد والصدر.
So this is armpit, i.e. his arm and his body.
وبين البطن والفخذ.
And between his stomach and his legs or his thighs.
وبين الفخذ والساق.
And between the thighs or the back of the legs and the shin. I mean, there has to be space between all of these three things.
هذا هو السجود الصحيح والله أعلم.
This is the correct prostration, Allah knows best.
ويحتاط من يصلي حتى لا تنكشف العورة من هنا.
And the person who's praying has to now take care so that his awra, his private part, is at the back is not uncovered.
الآن نطبق الأخطاء.
So now we're going to make mention of the errors, show the errors.
يضع رجليه هكذا.
To place the feet like this, or one foot on top of another,
يرفع رجلين كلاهما,
or he raises his feet on top of the ground, or he prays without, or he prostrates without making the space between his body. So you can see how his elbows and everything and his thighs are all together.
أو يفترش ذراعيه على الأرض كما يفترش السبع.
Or, for example, he places his elbows and his forearms on the earth, on the ground.
يمتد كأنه نائم من شدة ما يمتد. قدم كمان. لا. سجود نفسه لكن امتد جدا. أي هكذا يمتد جدا يعني.
Or a person he elongates his body so much as if he's lying down, he's made to go to sleep.
حتى لا يكون راكع يكون كأنه نائم.
As if he's sleeping and not prostrating.
يلا أو بعد ما ننتهي يطبق السجود.
طيب.
بعد ما ننتهي. أنجزها الآن.
So now we're going to move on to the sitting.
ماذا يقول في سجوده؟
Sorry, what does he say whilst he's prostrating in his sujood? What should he say? Put your hand up.
بقية ما نعرفه.
The rest of you don't know.
نعم. سبحان ربي الأعلى.
He has to say سبحان ربي الأعلى.
وهذا فيه إثبات العلو لله سبحانه وتعالى.
And in this is an affirmation of the علو of Allah, the fact that He is high.
نعم.
or above.
قال يا جارية أين الله؟ قالت في السماء.
So when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to the slave girl, where is Allah? She said, He's above the skies.
لابد أن يقول في سجود مرة واحدة سبحان ربي الأعلى وجوبا.
So the person who is praying has to say سبحان ربي الأعلى in the prayer at least once, and this is the obligation once.
ويستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And he can increase in saying things in the prostration according to that which has been narrated by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وكذلك هنا في السجود السجود موضع للدعاء موضع ومظنة لإجابة الدعاء لكن بماذا يدعو؟ نعم.
So the prostration, the sujood. So the sujood, it is the place to make dua. But what should he make dua with or for?
فيدعو بماذا؟
So what does he supplicate with?
الأولى أن يدعو بما ورد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
The best thing is to supplicate according to the supplications of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
لأن أدعية النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم جامعة مانعة.
Because the supplications of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they're comprehensive, meaning that they might be short words, but they cover a lot of meanings.
مثاله اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عني.
So an example of this is اللهم إنك عفو. Oh Allah, you are the one who pardons. You love تحب العفو. You love pardoning, so pardon me, forgive me.
فاعف عني في مال.
So forgive me in what? Pardon me in what?
في بدني.
In my body.
في مالي.
In my wealth.
في الدنيا.
In the world. Worldly life.
في القبر.
In the grave.
في الآخرة.
In the hereafter.
في ولدي.
My child.
في زوجي.
My wife.
تشمل خير الدنيا والآخرة.
So this includes the goodness of this world and the hereafter.
هل يصح أن يدعو باللغة الإنجليزية ممن لا يعرف اللغة العربية؟
Is it correct for a person to supplicate while he's in the sujood in English and he doesn't know the Arabic language?
يصح.
It is correct.
بشرط.
But with one condition.
أَلَّا يُغَيِّرَ الْأَسْمَاءَ الْحُسْنَى.
That he doesn't change the beautiful names of Allah.
يعني لا يصح أن يقول God.
So for example, it's not permissible for a person to quote Allah and say, Oh God.
ما يصح لأن God ليس من أسماء الله بل هذا من الإلحاد في أسماء الله.
This isn't correct because God is not from the names of Allah. Rather, this is a deviation in calling Allah.
هل يصح أن يقول Oh my God?
So is it correct for a person to say, Oh my God?
لا ما يصح.
It's not correct.
هذا إلحاد في أسماء الله.
This is from the types of deviation when it comes to the names of Allah.
أسماء الله تحكى كما هي.
The names of Allah, they are said or pronounced as they are.
يعني تقول يا الله.
Meaning you say, يا الله.
ثم يدعو باللغة الإنجليزية. أعطينا دعاء باللغة الإنجليزية.
So you can say, يا الله, and then you can make any supplication in the English language. So for example, I'm sure that young people say, oh Allah, give me
Allah اغفر لي.
Like, oh Allah, forgive me.
نعم. ولا يصح أن يقول, God,
and it's not permissible for a person to say, oh God, forgive me. You have to say, oh Allah, forgive me.
مفهوم؟
So is this understood?
فإذا سمعت أي إنسان يقول Oh my God تقول لا ما يصح.
So if you hear any person saying Oh my God, then you say to him this isn't correct.
هم أرادوا الكفار.
The disbelievers they wanted.
أرادوا أن يعلموا أهل الإسلام هذا الأمر.
The non-Muslims, the disbelievers, they want to teach this thing to the Muslims.
قول Oh my God.
So saying Oh my God.
Shit. اي نعم يعني دائما هم يعلموا الانسان اللعن.
So the worst that
يعني هذه الالفاظ كلها ارادوا ان يعلموا اهل الاسلام هذه. Oh my God وشت
كذا. So the Shaykh is teaching you that look, are the non-Muslims, they get people used to saying these type of insults. Even sometimes you say it without thinking it's a swear word. So these type of things you don't say.
لأنهم يكثروا من هذا.
Because they, the disbelievers, they always say these things.
والمسلم ليس باللعان.
And the Muslim, as the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, that the Muslim isn't somebody who insults.
نعم. إذن عندنا ألفاظ شركية وألفاظ منهي عنها.
So therefore we have words or phrases which involve shirk and phrases that are impermissible, haram.
وأراد الكفار أننا نأتي بها دائما خاصة عندما يغضب.
And the disbelievers, they want from us that we always say these things, especially when we become angry.
هو لا يقول هذا في المسجد صحيح. لكن عندما يغضب أحيانا يقول هذه الكلمة.
So a person wouldn't normally say this in the masjid. However, when he becomes angry, then he starts saying these words.
نعم. فماذا يصنع عند الغضب؟ أخذنا مر معنا أنه عند الغضب يقول إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون، لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله، اللهم أجرني في مصيبتي وخلف لي خيرا منها.
So what should a person say when he becomes angry? The things that the Sheikh mentioned. There's no might or power except Allah. Oh Allah, forgive me, and so on and so forth.
سب الدهر، لعن الدهر.
It's not permissible for a person to insult time or to curse time.
هاي كيف تبي تقول لعن الدهر وسب الدهر؟ نعم.
الله أعلم.
هذا إشكال.
في بعض العبارات.
طيب، إذن.
Sheikh, في عبارة في الإنجليزية.
أيوه.
You know, there's a phrase that you say, "All my days, يا أيامي."
هذا هو نداء الدهر.
So Allahu A'lam, maybe this phrase "all my days" meaning ya ayami, this maybe some type of so things like insulting time or days, this is what the people of Jahiliyyah used to say.
طيب اذا يصح ان يدعو بغير اللغه العربيه بشرط الا يغير الاسماء الحسنى.
So therefore in the prostration, the sujood, it is permissible for a person who doesn't know Arabic to make dua, to supplicate to Allah in a language other than Arabic, like English, with one condition, and that is that you only call Allah through His names, as they have been mentioned.
ثم بعد هذا.
And then after this.
أيضا يعني من الكلمات التي يعني أنا هذا الأعرف يعني كثرت السب واللعن ويعني القذف بالزنا وبكذا. نعم.
So, Sheikh, according to what I know, what often takes place is swear words all the time, insulting, you know, accusing people of things.
سواء كان هذا باللسان.
Whether this is upon one's tongue.
أو بالحركات باليد.
Or even in terms of the symbols that people use in their hands.
فالمسلم لا يمكن أن يصنع شيء من هذا.
So, Muslim cannot do either this, meaning swearing upon the tongue or even with his fingers and his hands.
مهما كانت الأسباب.
Whatever the reason is, whatever the cause is, a Muslim does not do this.
قل أبالله وآياته ورسوله كنتم تستهزئون.
Allah says in the Quran that say to them that were you mocking, were you making mockery of Allah and His verses and the Messenger?
فما بالك بسب الرب.
And then how about insulting Allah like some people do?
وسب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And insulting the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وسب الدين.
And insulting the religion.
بل نهينا عن سب آلهة الكفار في حضور الكفار حتى لا يؤدي هذا إلى سب الرب سبحانه وتعالى.
Rather we have been it has been forbidden for us to insult the deities or the false gods of the disbelievers in front of them, so it doesn't lead them to insulting Allah.
ثم بعد هذا يكبر ويجلس.
And then after this, a person says Allahu Akbar and he sits up.
إذا ما استطاع أنه يضع الرجلين هكذا يعني لأنه غير معتاد كيف يصنع؟ يتدرب قبل الصلاة، قبل الدخول في الصلاة يتدرب على الجلوس في الصلاة.
So as you can see from the brother,
اجلس على هذا.
His toes are down facing the Qibla, even the toes themselves. If a person isn't able to do this because he's not used to it, then before he prays, he needs to train himself to do this.
أي يعني تدرب على هذه الجلسة. يجلس هكذا ويسجد.
So for example, train yourself like this. Sit like this with your feet propped up.
أي نعم.
And then going to sujood.
ثم يجلس هكذا.
So his toes become like this.
ويسجد مرة أخرى حتى يعتاد على أن يضع باطن أصابع الرجلين على الأرض متجه بالأصابع للقبلة.
Up until a person is able to place the bottom of his toes down firmly on the ground facing the Qibla.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا يجلس بعد السجود يجلس.
So meaning the person isn't on his toes like this, rather the toes are facing the Qibla.
هذه الجلسة
like this.
في كل جلسات الصلاة. ينصب اليمنى ويجعل باطن أصابع اليمنى على الأرض ويتجب الأصابع للقبلة ويفترش اليسرى.
So this is the sitting that is done in all of the prayers, that a person sits on his left foot and props up his right foot, and the toes of his right foot are facing the qibla, firmly planted on the ground facing the qibla.
نعم هذا في كل جلسات الصلاة.
And this is in all of the sittings of the prayer.
بين السجدتين.
Between the two prostrations.
وفي التشهد الأول.
In the first tashahhud, the first sitting.
أما في التشهد الأخير إذا كانت الصلاة ثلاثية كالمغرب أو رباعية كالعشاء.
As for if there is a second sitting of tashahhud, i.e. if the prayer is three rak'at or four rak'at and there's a second sitting.
يتورك.
Then a person forms what they call a tawarruk.
يصح بأن يضع يدخل اليسرى من أسفل ساق اليمنى.
So the meaning of tawarruk is
ينصب اليمنى.
That he props up his right foot.
ويجعل اليسرى تحت ساق اليمنى.
And he makes his left foot come under the shin of his or over the shin of his right foot.
نعم.
It's easier to see than to describe.
ماذا يقول بين السجدتين؟
So what should a person say between his two prostrations? The rest of you don't know.
ماذا يقول؟
What should a person say when he sits up between the two prostrations, the two sujood? He
said,
you say رب اغفرلي. So you say رب اغفرلي.
نعم يقول رب اغفرلي.
He says رب اغفرلي.
مرة واحدة وجوبا.
He has to say it once as an obligation.
ويصح أن يزيد استحبابا رب اغفرلي رب اغفرلي أي الثالثة وهكذا.
And it's permissible for a person or recommended for a person to increase over one time, two or three times saying رب اغفرلي رب اغفرلي رب اغفرلي and so on.
هل يصح أن يقول رب اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمسلمين والمسلمات مثلا؟
Is it correct for a person to say like this, you know, increase رب اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين؟
لا.
No, it's not permissible.
هل يصح أن يقول ربنا ولك الحمد والشكر؟
Is it permissible when you stand from the ركوع that you say ربنا ولك الحمد والشكر؟
لا.
No.
لأن هذه الصلاة توقيفية.
Because the prayer it is a توقيفية, meaning the prayer can only be done in the way which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. So he did, and we stay away from that which he did not do. We can't invent things and add to things how we want.
ثم يسجد السجدة الثانية.
And then after sitting goes back into the second prostration.
ثم يقوم إلى الثانية الركعة الثانية.
And then he stands up to his for the second ركعة for the second unit.
يصنع في الركعة الثانية ما صنع في الركعة الأولى.
And he does the same actions in the second unit of prayer like he did in the first unit of prayer.
إلا أن الركعة الثانية ليس فيها تكبيرة إحرام.
Except in the second unit of prayer there is not تكبيرة الإحرام, the initial الله أكبر.
فيها تكبيرة انتقال بين السجدة الثانية والركعة الثانية.
But the الله أكبر that he says when he's getting up from the prostration is called تكبيرة الانتقال, meaning the تكبيرة for moving from one position to another position.
فإذا انتهى من الثانية جلس للتشهد.
So then if he has finished from his second rak'ah, meaning his sujood, then he sits for at-tashahhud, the sitting.
نعم. يضع باطن الكفين على أطراف الفخذين.
So he places the palms of his hands towards the edge of his thighs.
نعم. ويشير بالمسبحة والسبابة.
And he points with his index finger.
يحركها ويدعو بها.
And he moves it while supplicating, while making dua.
طيب. ثم بعد هذا إذا انتهى من التشهد يصلي الصلاة الإبراهيمية على النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And then once he has finished saying the tashahhud, then he sends salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as is in what they call الإبراهيمية. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم. Like this.
نعم. ثم يستعيذ بالله من أربع.
And then he seeks refuge in Allah from four things.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا يدعو بما ورد والأولى يدعو بما أحب والأولى يدعو بما ورد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And then after seeking refuge from these four things, then he can make dua for whatever he wants. And it is better to make dua with the supplications that have been narrated. So therefore, the positions or the places for supplication was in the prayer or two. In the prostration, the sujood. And then when you're sitting just before you say the taslim. And then the person he says, Assalamu alaykum rahmatullah, to his right and his left. Okay, the errors whilst making taslim.
تحريك الرأس هكذا قبل التسليم.
Moving the head up and down like this before you make التسليم.
أو تحريك اليدين أو الضرب على الفخذين.
أو moving your hands or hitting your thighs with your hands.
أو عند اليمين يحرك اليمنى عند اليسار يحرك اليسار.
Or like some people do when they make the seam towards the right, they move their right hand. And when they make the seam towards the left, they move their left hand.
أو ينحرف عن القبلة بمنكبين. يعني يقول السلام عليكم ورحمة الله هكذا.
Or for example, a person turns away or deviates away from the Qibla with his shoulders. So when he's making the first taslim, he moves all his body and his shoulders. Or when a person makes the taslim, goes to the right hand, when he brings it back to the center, he goes down, then he does left.
بهذا عندما يفرغ وينتهي من الصلاة هذه إذا كانت الصلاة ثنائية كالفجر.
So this, a person would complete the prayer if the prayer is only two units of prayer, like the Fajr prayer.
فإن كانت الصلاة ثلاثية أو رباعية.
And if the prayer is three units or four units.
بعد أن يفرغ وينتهي من التشهد.
After
التشهد الأول.
After a person has finished from his first tashahud, the first sitting.
يستحب له أن يقول الصلاة الإبراهيمية.
It is recommended for him to say the Salah Ibrahimiyya, the salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi
wasallam.
And then he says Allahu Akbar and he gets up for the third unit. So, just to repeat that, if a person is praying a prayer which has three units or four units, like the Maghrib prayer or the Isha prayer, after the first tashahud, whilst he's sitting, it's recommended for him to say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad and send salutations upon the Prophet. And then he stands up saying Allahu Akbar for the third unit of prayer.
عندما يقوم يرفع اليدين.
And when he stands up, then he raises his hand.
وقال أن الله أكبر.
And then he says Allahu Akbar whilst raising his hands.
ثم يصلي الثالثة والرابعة.
And then he prays the third unit of prayer and the fourth unit of prayer.
ويجلس التشهد ويسلم.
And then he sits down for the last sitting, the tashahud, and then he makes his taslim.
ففي هذا التشهد الأخير.
So in the final tashahud now,
يصلي الصلاة الإبراهيمية.
He says the salutations and the blessings upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
بعد التشهد.
After the tashahud.
واستعذ بالله من أربع.
And after seeking refuge, and then he seeks refuge from Allah in four matters.
ويدعو بما ورد.
And then he can supplicate with any supplication, but it's best to do that which has been narrated.
ثم يسلم.
And then he makes a taslim.
والحمد لله رب العالمين. والحمد لله.
الحمد لله.
نريد يعني الآن نطبق لنا السجود.
So now we want we want every single one of you facing the Qibla to make a sujood so we can check if there's any errors.
بعد المغرب هم يجتمعون الآن فيما بينهم.
Okay, so now all of you sit together in your groups.
ويطبقوا.
And pray the prayer, like pray for them one unit, and the others look at this unit and see if it's correct or not.
وبعد المغرب إن شاء الله نطبق صفة الوضوء والتيمم والاغتسال إن شاء الله.
And after the Maghrib prayer, we're going to go through the description of the wudu and the description of at-tayammum and the description of the ghusl.
والله أعلم.
And Allah knows best.